Welcome to the oldest university observatory in the world that's still in use. This is where, in the 17th century, the stars were first observed up close after the discovery of the telescope, not by Galileo, but by a Dutchman. And what does this building have to do with Albert Einstein? Follow us through the fascinating history of this observatory, its scientists, and the origins of astronomy. We are in Leiden, the Netherlands, where in the Hortus Botanicus of the country's oldest university, you'll find a somewhat hidden observatory. Its story begins in 1608. When lens maker Hans Libri from Middelburg applied for a patent for a refracting telescope, which he believed was very suitable for spying on enemies from a distance. The invention spread rapidly throughout 17th century Europe, but became famous when Galileo improved it and had the brilliant idea to use it not to study enemies, but the starry sky in his work Sidereus Nuncius. This revolutionary work sparked a fascination with the undiscovered starry sky throughout Europe. At the University in Leiden, founded by William of Orange in 1575, an observatory was officially founded in 1633 when Professor Jacobus Golius had this platform installed on the academy building to observe astronomical phenomena. In 1689, the first telescope in a covered dome was installed on another platform on the roof. Of these towers, a very early photo from 1859 is even known in archives, which has been colored here with the help of AI. The university was open to the public back then, so can you imagine visiting and being one of the first people to see the mighty universe up close, back when electricity didn't even exist? But this, in fact, was difficult for astronomers, because the large influx of curious people made it difficult to make accurate measurements. This, combined with the vibrations of nearby church bells that disrupted measurements, led to a poor international reputation for the observatory. Several directors attempted to change this, but due to a lack of funds, this was never successful until 1853, when Frederik Kaiser began lobbying vigorously to build a new observatory to prevent Utrecht from becoming the center of astronomy in the Netherlands. But not only in Utrecht were people less pleased with his competitive spirit. Biologists at Leiden University also resented his enthusiasm when he set his sights on a section of their Hortus Botanicus as the site for his state-of-the-art observatory. Kaiser was oblivious. Surely herbalism couldn't be overshadowed by such a grand science as astronomy? After intensive lobbying, he managed to have his dream observatory built for almost 132,000 guilders, of which he had raised 26,000 through crowdfunding. In January 1859, work began on driving 1,500 piles into the marshy ground next to the water. After Kaiser also had a dispute with the contractor, who, in his opinion, wanted to build too beautifully without paying enough attention to astronomical functionality, the observatory was completed in December 1860. It was almost four times more expensive and much grander than the one in Utrecht. Kaiser had won. This very first photo from 1861 shows not only that the observatory was subsequently expanded several times, but also that outside the Leiden Canal, there was still farmland instead of buildings, providing an unobstructed view to the south. The smallest southern dome still houses the observatory's oldest telescope from 1838, a 6-inch MERS refractor, which is therefore older than the observatory itself, and once stood on the aforementioned roof of the Academy building. The larger north dome of the building behind it houses a more powerful telescope from 1885, but is maybe more famous because it holds an Albert Einstein secret. A then unknown, recently graduated student, Albert Einstein applied in Leiden in 1901 to work as an assistant in the physics laboratory, but was rejected. But after publishing his theory of relativity in 1905, he quickly rose to fame, and from 1916 onward, he regularly visited Leiden, often visiting the homes of scientist friends like Willem de Sitter and Paul Ehrenfest, as seen here in a family photo from 1920. That year, he was also appointed a special professor in Leiden, and this chair from 1861 is said to have been his seat during several observations with a telescope in the North Dome. Another interesting fact is that in both rooms under the telescopes, there is a pillar, as they are founded separately from the building for maximum stability. In addition to the two observation domes, the West Wing was the residence for Director Kaiser, and other staff members lived in the East Wing. His new observatory achieved the prestige Kaiser hoped for, and the complex was gradually expanded several times, such as in 1878 with this heliometer tower, which since 1939 has housed the only telescope made in Leiden, the Sundermann reflector. A fun fact about this tower is that astronomers observing here often wore Russian flight suits from the First World War to stay warm on cold nights. But the most impressive telescope on the site is located in the newest Eastern Tower, which dates from 1925. Its photographic telescope dates from 1897 and still is the largest refracting telescope in the Netherlands. But the fact that it remains the largest also demonstrates that around the observatory centenary, the golden age of the imposing building was also slowly coming to an end. The many houses that had sprung up on the other side of the canal since the observatory was originally built and scientific discoveries made the iconic location increasingly unsuitable. Necessary mechanical and electronic workshops, as well as computer terminals, led to the relocation of more and more facilities to the university's Huygens Laboratory outside the city. And astronomy itself has also developed, so that measurements are now primarily conducted in high-altitude dark mountainous regions, such as the Very Large Telescope in Chile. Due to its historical value, the observatory was restored between 2009 and 2011, and the iconic building is now used as a faculty for law students. But of course, astrology students can still practice to their heart's content on the once technically most advanced telescopes in the prestigious observatory, are Professor Frederik Kaiser. Thanks for watching, and see you again in one of our next videos.